What is the truth? Ebranians 7, part 14. If you still live in legalized, then you cannot live in life. Jesus' blood washed over sins over the cross. Of course, you should avoid anything, but if you do, you can be forgiven. Legalized cannot bring perfection. Only Jesus, the life, does. Jesus tells us that he lives in us and we live in him. Since we are baptized, then have pure and beautiful life to make him happy and pleased. The former regulation became cancelled by holy hope. Then holy hopes are greater than former regulation. It takes about security in your life because we are living in eternal life in Jesus. Then we are living in peace and rest, and the greater things draw and lead and closer us to the God of by in time mercy and love. Jesus cleans us for meeting the God by purity and love. Legalized points on our impurity and justice, which kept us away from the God. Since Abraham, people offered a lamb to the God, people offered an animal to be forgiven. But Jesus gave his life over the cross to save human and restore human to the God's kingdom. You live in Jesus and Jesus in you. Then don't make him disappointed. Be pure and lively and purposeful. When you bend in front of him and fall on knees in front of him, he blesses us and forgives us, and we can live in peace and rest. Then pure and close to God is greater than impure and instant. Therefore, I tell that Christ is the way to heaven, not a religion legalized. Ibrahim didn't accept any offer from dictators when they recommended him because he believed on God's kingdom. To live in new life with Jesus rather than in the old life is greater. He makes the way and new life. Then trust in him and take the steps. Amen. Sometimes when people change their promises or ideologies, others lose wonderful things. Example is marriage. They stay in front of the God and Jesus and promise until death differ them. But before that, they divorced and them and their children step in hard situation. When you lose a job, you step in hard situation. Have you thought what is happening if God changes his mind against you? If we do something wrong to cause this, there is hope to find them back. Christ tells us if we trust Jesus, he saves and saves us. When we are in Jesus and Jesus in us, we haven't any fear that Jesus or God change their mind about us. But what cause if you change your mind against the God and Jesus? It can be forgiven if you confess your mistake. But if you expand your mistakes over the others, you are demon and fail, because God protects his people. I remind the beginning of the creation. Human failed by their sin, but God let Adam and Eve know that it comes a man who saves the human. This good news made them happy. We are living in 22 years after, and we believe on Jesus and his miracles. And his wonderful messages and his rescue plan. God completes his purpose and promise. In generation 14, we learned about MS and that he is high priest and he met Abraham. In generation 15, we learned about God's promise to Abraham. This promise is greater than a contract. God promised Abraham to give him generations, and that it comes a person who blesses all his generations. That person was Moses, 400 years after Abraham. People between Moses and Jesus are Moses' generation. God's 10 commandments made people holy and prepared for Jesus to defeat Satan and his demon. Easy here. It made the sacrifice system, which is Jesus' life on the cross, defeating Satan and his demons. There were also the Levians, priesthood, who helped people be strong in their beliefs. These are the old covenant. God talked about David and that he made David's generation. God tells him about a king who reigns forever, and that person is Jesus. In Psalm 110, God reminds us on MS and points on Jesus, who came from MS Road. After total 1,000 years of faith and on successes of human, 600 years after Moses, Jesus is born and new covenant started. In Hebrew, it talks how old covenant leads to new covenant. In all seasons or prophecies, God talked and pointed on Jesus because it was the plan. Hebrews 7, part 11 and 19. All covenants are based on legalized, which could be old with years. But new covenants is life and cannot be changed or old because it is eternal. Jesus' eternal life and existence keeps everything fresh and new. The perfection. God's plan is restoring human to his kingdom and cannot be changed or old. The existence have been since a long, long, long time ago without changing. Therefore, God's plan is perfection and valid in any time. Jesus is our hope, keeping us closer to the God and having a very lovely relationship with him. God doesn't change his plan. Part 20, it appears a question, how we know that it doesn't come another after Jesus? All covenants became priests without swearing, while Jesus is the most high eternal priest because of the God's promise in Psalm 110. Part 22, because of this swear, Jesus became the guarantors of the new covenants, where the God's holy promises executed. Part 23, because all covenants became past, God created another new ones. Jesus has eternal life. He lives in us and we in him. Therefore, God's plan and grace, perfection executed, means that his high priesthood and his reigning is eternal. It has been done only once and is complete. Jesus forgives our sins, and each time we will talk with the Father, he cleans us. Jesus doesn't give up you. Make him happy and proud. He makes us holy. As long as he is the highest holy, then don't disappoint him. Jesus doesn't only support the good people. He puts his job on bad people who are lost. In Matthew stands, the doctor tries to treat sick and sick people, not healthy ones. When you live in Jesus, who is sitting in the right-hand side of God, then you are really there. When you trust and live your life in Jesus' hand, you are not failed. Keep your relationship with him beautiful and thankful. Jesus is God's complete plan and grace, the perfection. It cannot be changed or replaced with other. Hallelujah. Amen. In Old Covenant, where they were legalized, you should obey God's law to be blessed and holy. If you denied and didn't obey, God punished. I confess that I have lived in legalization. I all the time have tried to do good things to make God and Jesus happy and pleased. Trust Jesus and God, but unfortunately demons and evils remove over our head a lot of their dirty-minded thinking to make us a sinner in front of the God and Jesus. I have lived in something between the old and new covenant. Now I have found the truth, Christ's lifestyle. Thanks God and Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. In New Covenant, Hebrews 8, part 1 to 3, Jesus washes our sins by his blood over the cross. Jesus is sitting in the right hand of the God. We who live in Jesus and Jesus in us can imagine that we are also sitting at right side the hand of the God. But it is Jesus judge if we do or not, depending on our duties. As like as other prophets in Old Covenant had duties, Jesus had duties which was greater and better. Old Covenant is a shadow, while New Covenant is real. Old promises were a preparation for new promises, which are greater and better than realities. Part 7. When new promises are real, then there is no reason to accept other promises thereafter. New Covenant is based on real promises, not a good function. It talks about three basics of promises. Internal Activity 10, God tells that he puts his ruling in our mind and heart. He lets Holy Spirit works inside us and makes us unit and replaces our stone heart and meaty. God's words become meat, our body. And soften our soul proper to execute his words. Then we get the heart God has created you from the beginning. Jesus, based on his soul inside us, works on our internal activity in front of external activity. I think that the external activities is a projection of our internal activities. Friendly relationship 10. It doesn't matter which position you have, you are a child of God, because God will let people know him and know about the truth and perfection and his grace, restoring human to his kingdom. Hallelujah. Amen. 3. Forgiveness 12. Jesus forgives and forgets sins. It is old and doesn't exist. Heavenly Father God and Jesus, let me recognize when you and Holy Spirit talk with me and break your words in my mind and heart. Let me be your proud example and tell me how easy can fulfill your purpose to be a part of your plan. In the heavenly, powerful and strong name of Jesus, amen. It's about sins and forgiveness. It stands in the scripture that someone made adultery and killed the man to cover his sin. He became in trouble morally and he asked God for forgiveness and he became forgiven. Thereafter, he wrote about the God's grace and kindness. Conscience is a small judging inside you. Even before you will do something, it says you if it is correct or wrong. It's inside everybody. Those people who continue to commit crimes and sins, they cannot hear the judge anymore, because with their crimes, they have already killed their conscience. That when some people go to the end bed, a voice reminds them their badly works. It says that no crime becomes forgotten because the conscience knows about them. Hebrews 9, part 1 to 8, before it talks about Holy Spirit's job inside us, internal activity, which reflects on our external activity. In Moses' generation, it was built a temple which had an inside room, which has another room. The outer room is called courtyard. The inside room is called holy place, and its inside room is called most holy place. In holy place, it was a candle and a table filled with 12 loaves of bread. Each week they renewed In the most holy place, there were treasures and fumigation and coffin, God's mercy's bed. In this place, they met God. The usual Jewish didn't know how to meet the God. They gave offering, but it wasn't enough to clear their conscience, witness of our actions. Part 9. In New Covenant, it talks about God's grace bed, God's kingdom. Part 10. There are two covers between us and the God. One which covers the holy place and the other is our conscience. When you clear your conscience, maybe confessing, but put away the cover and you come closer to the God. God puts away the cover by Jesus' sacrifice and accepts Jesus' followers to his kingdom. Hallelujah. Amen. Part 11. But Jesus won over all these things. The most holy place is God's kingdom. Just left this world with his blood and raised to the heaven after defeating the dead. He rescued us. Jesus' blood cleared our conscience from them leading us to the death, because he wants us to praise the God with a pure and friendly relationship. Heavenly Father God, let us hear our conscience if we do wrong, and let us correct our actions to live healthy in Jesus and Jesus peacefully in us. Amen. When Jesus forgives us, he cleans our conscience too.